I moved to Canada several years ago to start a PhD program. A big miracle that I've experienced in the past several years is finding joy and finding community. It may seem like a really small thing, but when you're a young person and you've moved to a new area and you don't have any friends or any family nearby, you can be very lonely. But having a connection with God and every morning being able to start my day with Him, as well as each week being able to experience community at church, that has not only strengthened my faith, but brought me friends. One thing that really drew me to Oak Ridge Adventist Church was their online presence. Even before I had moved to Canada, I was listening to sermons from OAC pastors and checking out their social media presence. And so when I came to OAC and I had the opportunity to volunteer on online chat, that was absolutely incredible. So online chat is a global community of visitors who are worshiping with the church community, but online. And these are people who are listening in from South America, from Europe, from Africa, and from around Canada. So not only are we helping out a global community, but even a local community. If you think about it, there are people in British Columbia or in Vancouver that due to health, due to travel reasons, can't always attend a local church. So every Sabbath that I'm volunteering for online chat, I'm saying, welcome, how are you? I'm really glad that you're worshiping with us today. We're engaging with comments. And during prayer times, we're taking time to pray with the online viewers. So one thing that we were taught in kind of our introduction to going on online chat is how to answer prayer requests. And you know, we get lots of prayer requests that come in, and this isn't something that we completely just gloss over. We immediately pray with the online viewer, and then throughout the week, the administration staff, as well as the pastoral team, continues to pray for those prayer requests. And it really is a blessing to communicate and to connect, and we can also see that we have a family of online worshipers. So there will be certain people that we'll see each week, and it's always great to see a message pop by and we're like, oh, I recognize you. How are you doing today? How have you seen God moving in your life? And to really grow as a global community with them. One of the greatest blessings of online chat is when the online experience becomes an in-person experience. And I know we've had visitors who say, you know, I'm here today because I was engaged in the online community. And for online volunteers to be able to meet someone that they've only connected with through chats and tweets, it's an incredible experience. When I first moved here, one Bible verse that spoke to my heart was Isaiah 41, verses 9 and 10. And here, God promises, look, I know you're in the farthest corners of the earth, but I've chosen you, I've called you, you're my servant and my friend. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. I think this is what community is all about, reaching out, engaging, and worshiping together. As a Christian, we're called to service. And you can serve in many different ways. You can give of your time, your talents, and tithe. Find ways where you can integrate your skills to help your church community. This is what I get to do each week in online chat. How are you called to serve?